The Petaluma Radio Players.
Like talking on air.
And now, the Petaluma Radio Players, located just north of the Golden Gate Bridge in Northern California's Sonoma County, bring you another provocative radio drama from their home on www.kpca.fm. Our drama during this week's presentation is yet another comedy of chilling proportions, The Misadventure of the Disgruntled Physician by UK playwright Vince Stadon. Featuring world-famous sleuth Sherlock Holmes and his trusty cohort in crime-solving Dr. Watson, our latest drama poses a diagnosis most diabolical. Has Sherlock Holmes lost his mind? What would make him execute a poor, helpless pig and in the living room of 221B Baker Street? Or is this a matter of some convenience? Did Mrs. Hudson forget to go shopping for breakfast bacon?
I am not a man who concedes easily to feelings of melancholia, but the weeks leading up to Christmas Day 1894 were somewhat difficult for me. I was still in mourning for my second wife, or was it my third, who had passed away that autumn, and when my thoughts turned to spending Christmas without her, it was with sorrow. I had promised myself that I would choose a potential new wife at the earliest opportunity. This would not be too difficult, since scarcely a day would pass without some fetchingly distressed young lady bustling into our rooms, begging for our help. Indeed, I already had my eye on a beautiful young creature called Miss Violet Spedding, who had only yesterday called upon Sherlock Holmes to help her father, who had been charged with the gruesome murder of a London banker. The poor, stunningly attractive young lady would need a shoulder to cry on as Holmes carried out his investigations, and I would selflessly offer up my services as comforter in her hour of need. No woman could resist such thoughtful treatment, and I had no doubt that the delectable Miss Violet would soon fall for my charms. But in the meantime, I had Christmas to endure. And since I'd moved back into 221B Baker Street, I also had to endure the company of the erratic and unpredictable Mr. Sherlock Holmes. It was Christmas Eve, and I was just finishing my breakfast.
Watson! Watson! Your revolver! Quickly, if you please!
Holmes! Are you in danger?
Not at the minute, but I fear I shall be if Mrs. Hudson gets to see our visitor. Hence the need for some urgency, my good fellow.
Visitor? Whatever are you talking about, Holmes?
Hurry, you swine!
Well, really, Holmes, there's no need. That's absolutely uncalled for, such rudeness.
Not you, Watson. Now, your revolver, please.
Here. It is loaded. Now, perhaps you would be so kind as to... Good heavens! It's a pig!
Your powers of observation astound me, Watson.
A pig?
Rather splendid, isn't he? I call him John, because he never seems to stop eating, like a certain doctor I know.
A pig!
Don't be too hard on yourself, Watson.
What are you going to do with him, Holmes?
This! Stand back, Watson.
Holmes, you're not going to... My God, you have! Holmes, have you gone insane?
Just a moment, Watson. I haven't quite finished. Now, where did I put that axe?
Holmes.
Ah, here it is. Watson, would you be so kind as to take 3 paces forward, please? Better make that 4 paces forward, I think.
Holmes, I implore you, put down that axe.
That's just about perfect, Doctor. Thank you. Stand right there and don't move.
Holmes!
One more, Watson!
Holmes, I am appalled. Your treatment of that poor, defenseless animal was sickening. You have a total disregard for anyone's feelings. For heaven's sake, man, it's Christmas Eve. And above all else, Holmes, if you haven't noticed, I am now drenched in blood.
Oh, do calm down, Watson. And yes, I had noticed that you are covered in blood. Indeed, that is the entire point of the exercise.
You brought a pig to our rooms, shot it 6 times with my revolver, and then slaughtered it with an axe, simply so that you could amuse yourself by covering me in its blood?
Steeped in blood, as Macbeth would have it. Now, Watson, I can't waste a moment. I must hurry to Lestrade to tell him all about this. You're going to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.